Clapping.
I think that clapping. Song's taken Lex from the Joyce Meyer collection, Life in the Word.
Oh, frizzy hair.
I love clothes. Her.
Yeah, my mum likes her too. She takes her every morning.
Me too.
Welcome back. This is the fourth and final segment, and we have been joined by nobody, and we have nothing to tell you about, really.
No.
Got a bit of a... I haven't been near anyone.
Well, we did have a 10-minute break.
Who's been...
You were gone a while.
Putting pivot hairs in my mouth.
Bed.
Okay, we are going to now go to a roving interview performed by our esteemed executive producer, the Love Kitten, and he's talking to two boys that have just gone through a commitment ceremony. So let's see what they have to say.
Oh, fool.
It's romantic.
I thought scallops down the front.
In studio B.
Thanks, Paul. Here we are in Studio B, and I am talking to Tim and Kieran, who are a married couple, or what we call in gay society as a married couple. Now, you guys have taken it one step further. You've actually done a celebrating ceremony, commitment ceremony.
Yes.
And so, why?
Why not?
Well, what are your... options like could you actually legally become married in Australia?
No. Federal legislation doesn't recognise gay relationships at all. Doesn't recognise gay de facto relationships.
How do you go about having a ceremony? Did you just look in the phone book under gay ceremonies? Or?
Well, we started doing that and we found it was a bit trickier than that. It actually took a bit of work to actually. Sort of sort out, okay, what is a commitment ceremony, how do we set it up, what do we need to organise, who do we get to do it?
So how did you go about it?
We talked about it, talked about what we wanted, what we didn't want.
No, but how did you find someone to do the ceremony? If there are people out there watching, yeah. That want to get married.
The also guide, under celebrants, civil
there
celebrants.
There we go, look in the also guide. Yeah. Now, I understand you two met on the internet.
Yes, we did. Yes.
What did you think when you saw each other for the first time?
I remember walking down the street and seeing Tim walking towards me. It was 9 o'clock at night. I remember thinking, oh yeah, he's a bit cute. Okay.
And Tim?
Pretty much the same thing. Actually, I was I'd actually send his pic over the internet, so I kind of knew what he was like.
Okay.
But then when I saw him turn around and went, oh, you actually are quite.
So you went for a coffee, and yes. Then how did it develop from there? You started going out, and how long before you actually, did the deed, so
well,
to speak.
We snogged that night. After coffee, Kieran came back to my place and
Tim corrected my psychology essay while I played on his CDs. And then I sort of thought, well, it's nearly 1 o'clock. I need to go home.
Gee, that was really nice. I'd like to snog you.
Can I snog you? And I sort of launched myself like a built-in nuclear missile.
Yes, but he beat me by about 30 seconds.
And how long before you you just started going out together from that point?
No, it was my birthday. That was the Thursday night. It was my birthday on the Saturday. Tim rang up Friday morning and invited himself to my birthday, and I was a bit oh, okay. We discovered we actually had a mutual friend, but we'd never actually met. So Tim and John came to my birthday. Tim and I spent most of the night snogging and ended up fucking in someone else's bed.
Yay!
Yay!
Well, that's what I call a success story. Now, after that, it was another 3 months and you moved in together.
Essentially, yeah. I mean, Kieran was sort of spending a lot of time at my place because he was living at home, so it was a little, not hugely awkward because his parents are very accepting.
So, but from woe to go, how long did it take from meeting over the internet for you to be able to go through a commitment ceremony?
Well, it was about 15 months.
Okay, yeah. And that was four or 5 months ago?
Yes.
Yeah, November 27, 1999.
Now, you act as a married couple? Financial melded in together?
No, actually, somebody asked me this the other day. Also, obviously, you'd have a joint bank account. And I said, bugger off, what's mine is mine, what's two
modern boys, I tell you, modern boys.
No, we are modern
boys.
But we're equal with our... I mean, we have separate
accounts. We share.
Accounts, we share.
Do you fight?
Not as a rule, no.
No, very rarely. No.
Have you ever had a fight?
We've had a few arguments.
I think one night you were a bit upset and so you had to slam the door and it was like, oh, Tim slammed the door, maybe I better stop sulking.
but generally we've... and that was, well into over 12 months into the relationship before the first door slam, and there hasn't been one since. But we've always been very good at communicating and talking to each other and telling each other how we're feeling or how we're not feeling or, you know.
Using those really trendy psychological terms like when you, I feel.
A question that everyone out there would love me to ask you. Are you planning any children?
We've got a cat called Kylie.
Does that count?
Hello
to Kylie the cat.
We've joked about adopting Romanian babies, but...
Kieran,
yep.
Do you write your name on your milk?
Really hard.
All right. That was a piece of footage from an interview that Stephen did with Kieran and Lee.
Tim.
Yeah. And Kieran is actually the fabulous Nan McGregor's son, and we'd all know Nan from Bent TV P-flag. And also from P Flag. So, hello, Nan.
Hi, Nan.
Was she at the ceremony?
She would have been bridesmaid.
Because there was the pictorial and outrage. So, if you've got that, you can
feed back
through
too.
That.
Okay, now.
But we don't want to talk about that anymore.
We don't know. Because we're going to go
to another piece of.
Footage! Funny there. And this one is a little bit racy. Now, Laura, I told you before that you had to go to bed when there was all that vile language.
Yep.
You definitely have to go to bed now because I don't want your mother chastising
you. And everyone at DT's, you can turn the sound up now.
Absolutely. It is a bit risque. So
this is my final warning to you.
Sexual stimulation. Stimulation sex offends you. Chew not. But let's have a look now. Sorry, Derek.
Racy.
Oh my God. Doing it or not?
think there was not, actually.
Do you think there was actual penetration?
Well, probably not.
Not with those.
It was called pokies.
Not with those bits of dental floss.
That was, of course.
That was the fabulous Miss Terri Tinsel.
And who were the male dancers? Graham Pengilly.
Hmm.
And George D. Who I knew vaguely and...
Vaguely?
Yeah, vaguely.
That's not what you were saying. Before you said you knew him.
Intimately. Yeah, well, we did the rehearsals for that show.
All right. All right, you staged the choreography.
Exactly.
The slapping of thighs.
We've had Terri this week. Can we have Deborah Legay clips next week?
And
Renee Scott clips? No, no.
That was from a pokies show that Terri produced back in 1988 for all those queens that remember. And I think... that was my first year here in Melbourne, so I wouldn't know. And pokies means something else in Victoria now, but there's no drag queens, just lots of...
scrubbers. No, they don't do that anymore. They just push the buttons.
Leaving their children in cars to be exasperated.
And the little kiddies.
That's right, their children and their little kiddies and their dogs. All right, now we're going to have the final news, views and his views from Reece Rubber-Dick. Take it away, Reece.
Thanks, Reece.
All right. I know this has been done on Squeal before, but Joy Melbourne, 90.7. Look, we'd like to hear it full time. They're looking for members, okay? You can find their number in Brother Sister. I suggest you give them a call and become a member. All right, and last but not least, a bit of pop music news. The two Melbourne sisters, S2S, they're touring with five boy bands. Okay, now they've made a success, and their new single is due out very soon. Okay, that's all from the news desk.
That's very good, Tabitha.
Thank you.
Did you go to life drawing classes? Very fabulous. All right, now, where's Rubes?
Rubes is down here.
We've got a very special little guest here today, and we're going to try and get
sister.
Ruby. Oh, look, it's
Ruby.
Very dark.
Look,
we can't see it at all.
That's
little
see
Mikey.
Poor Ruby.
Dog Ruby.
There she is. Get up, girl.
Ruby, come on, darling. Come on, Ruby.
Come home to mama.
Come on.
Yeah, one dog.
Come on, darling. Come on. Can I lift her up?
One dog to another.
Oh, come on, Ruth.
She probably wouldn't.
No, she's
but that's because we've got 400,000 dogs in Melbourne.
Poop City.
Absolutely. 400,000 dogs.
All right.
And I'm not one of them.
No, you're not, but this woman is, but she's in Queensland. Okay. That's my view. And my opinion.
Chelsea
and
I'm didn't glad to. That at all.
What'd you say, Chelsea Clinton?
Channel 31.
Oh, Channel 31. All right.
It's winding furiously.
Winding time, yes. So that means that we have to go... and ramble on. Oh, how do they even shake like they're real?
Because they are real.
That's amazing. Thank you, Dean Francis. And don't forget, guys, to check in on Dean's sitcom at www.jjsplice.com.au. Also,
Strange
Bits of Passion. You can visit their website as well, Strange Bits of Passion. That's it. We're out. Tabitha, thank you.
Thanks.
Michael, thank you. Reece, thank you. Watch us again next week. Bye. I don't know if you can hear me.
Hey, come and check me out.
Go and check me out.
I'm single already. The best thing you did is when you said to me, let's get popping to the beat. Let's walk a walk. We did do and don't we? We did popping off. Let's get popping to the beat. Let's walk a walk. We did do and don't we? Tonight, you and I, you and I, you and I.
This program is proudly sponsored by DT's Hotel, where every colour of the rainbow drinks, corner of Hyatt and Church Streets, Richmond.
It's a long way to Wagga Wagga, it's a long way to go. It's a long way to Wagga Wagga, to the sweetest girl I know.
Miss, you're a lesbian, miss.
No, I'm bisexual, swinging door, double adapter, call me what you will.
Well, can we watch Girl Talk, then? I don't think we're supposed to have fun while we're doing this, but nevertheless, can we watch Girl Talk? Because she's going to see the Queer Film Festival opening and all the queer people there. Sweaty.
Okay, I think that's a great idea, but we better do the weather first.
Oh, okay, if we must. Tonight and tomorrow will remain fine, with a little rain at times. Then there'll be southwest to southerly winds, and it will be locally fresh during the afternoon and the evening, and a minimum of 17 and a maximum of 21.
Wednesday, becoming fine with a maximum of 19. Thursday, mostly fine with a maximum of 19. And Friday, mostly fine again with a minimum of 13 and a maximum of 22. The weekend should also remain fine and mild.
Oh, damn spots. Ouch.
Don't pick at them, though.
Time to watch Girl Talk. Watch it. We'll see you soon.
Bye.